What's going on, everybody? Welcome to Hof Bergmann. This map is just absolutely amazing. I mean, I cannot believe the detail on this map. This is insane. Everything that you could do on this map is just crazy. Apparently, this was a thing for 19. I didn't know anything about it. So, yeah. I'm playing it now. It's amazing. So, I've gone around, changed some equipment and stuff, added a few things, taken a few things away, and all of that. So, yeah, let's take a look around, and then we'll get into it. So, here's the house that you start off with. This bike and this little wagon right here is stored in here originally. But I took it out, and I put the Nissan truck that it starts you off with. I put that in here. So, there that is. And so we'll come out here and kind of work our way around. We'll start over here. We have this. This is the, I'm going to pronounce this wrong or something. It's the Schluter. Something like that. But yeah, it's, I think it's got like 200 something horsepower. It's a mid-ground, you know, tractor that we can use to do a couple of things. We got this one over here. This is our small tractor. I think it's only got 150 horsepower, but it is the, what is this, the Fortschritt? I think that's how you say it. We have a little wagon over here that it starts you off with. I went ahead and just left that because I didn't know if I was going to need it or not necessarily. So, yeah, we'll, let's go ahead and close. Actually, let's leave it open so we can kind of keep track of where we've been. So in here is the horse stables. And this, it starts you off with this, the Schaefer, or Schaefer. But yeah, this is basically like a little front loader machine. Pretty nice. I got some forks and a bucket for it. No horses at the moment. We'll get to those at some point in time. So, yeah, let's come out here. There's nothing on that side over here. We have our fill point for stuff. And this is open. Yep, okay. So over here we kept the Pottinger that it starts you off with for the grass, the forage wagon. We have a class round baler with a wrap on the back of it so we can make silage bales if needed. We also have a silage bunker that we're going to be using, or a bunker silo that we're going to be using for the silage also. So we'll be doing bales and silage in the bunker silo. So we have the coon. This is just for standard round bales for like grass, hay, and straw. Then we have a square baler, the Massey Ferguson, that will give us some square bales. And I'll show you why I have this variety of balers here in just a second. So if we come out from here, we'll come over here and check out this area. Outside, we kept the universal tank that comes with the LSFM Innovations mod pack that the map creator added into this setup, so it can hold a lot of different liquids and stuff. So back here we have a 6-meter plow that we'll start off with. I got a kind of like a mix of new and old equipment. I think it fits really well with this farm, with this map. So that's kind of where I'm going with that. So we have our cultivator here. I believe this is like a 9-meter, or no, 7.4. meter. So over here, let's open this up. We have our big tractor to do a lot of the heavy work that the smaller stuff cannot handle. This is the Fendt 942 Vario. We'll be using this for plowing, I believe, because I think that takes like 300 horsepower. I'm not sure. Cultivating, I think we're definitely going to have to use this. Yeah, or we may be able to use the red tractor over there. But that's there for big stuff. We're going to be getting into manure and slurry on this map as well. And I'll show you some of the equipment over there that we have for that. This came with the map. And I was going to get rid of it, and I was like, you know what? This might be kind of handy to have. So, yeah, I left it in. It's got this little bin on the front. I think it has a capacity, a very low capacity. And you could also put, you know, pallets and stuff up there as well. But yeah, it's a vent. So from here, let's go into the next one. So over here, all I have left is the trailer that came preset on the map. This will be good for pallets and moving small equipment if needed. So from there, we'll come out here. We have a little diesel tank. You might notice that there's some trigger markers missing, but there's trigger markers here, so don't worry. Yeah, you can see right there, 8,000 liters of diesel is what it starts you off with. So from here, let's open up here. Okay, yeah, so I just moved a little wheelbarrow in here. This is the pig pen, the pigsty. We're not going to get into pigs right away. We'll get there eventually. My goal is to go through every feature on this map at some point. So, and then if you know anything about the Hof Bergmann, it's constantly evolving, constantly updating. So I'm going to try to get through all of the features that are on the map now. That way it is covered, and then when the map gets an update, I'll revisit, and it'll just be a continuous series throughout the Hof Bergmann lifespan in FS22. So from here, we have our cedar and the tank for the front, because this doesn't have a capacity. So we have the cedar. Figured I would try something new. You know, I kind of tend to stick to the same equipment over and over, so I'm mixing it up and trying something new. So we have this one right here. Then we have the tank for the front of it that holds the seed and the fertilizer. So that's good. We'll take a look in here. This is an added mod that I put in. This is a telehandler, the Merlot Turbo Farmer. It's a very nice model. I like it. It kind of has like an old machinery vibe to it. So I have some bale forks for it. I'll be using the bale forks quite a bit in this. And then over here, we can go ahead and open these doors. All three doors do open. Over here, we have our New Holland. This is the CH770 harvester. And we just have a basic grain header and a trailer to pull it. So, this was a pain to back in here. Just going to point that out right now. let's see. Where should we go next? Let's go this way. So, this right here is a pretty cool feature. If we do this right here, there's an option to take these walls down. I can't remember what it is. Maybe I just don't have a hotkey or something set up for it. But yeah, you can make these walls disappear if you wanted to, but I'm going to leave them there. Kind of like the challenge of being able to get in, having to get in here. So this right here is one of the bales. This is absolutely... It's insanity. This is what this is. It's amazing. I love it. It's beautiful, but it's insanity. This is bale storage. So you walk up to it and you get into it just like you would a vehicle. Press E. Now you can see it holds 54 bales. If we go to... It is in German. Holy smokes. If we go... B. Okay, hold on. Yeah, Y. Okay, you press Y first, and then you can... it takes the tarp off. You can access your bales, take what you need, and then when you're done, you hit B. It will restack all of the bales that are left, and then put the tarp and store them. I mean, how amazing is that? Why can this not be a thing on every single map? It's amazing. I love it. Like I said, it's insanity, but it's beautiful. beautiful insanity. I love it. Anyways, let's move on. That's enough of that. That's so cool. Alright, so let's pop into this real quick. We kind of have our grass care section over here, as well as a standard roller for the field. So we have our grass roller right here. We have a windrow back here. We have a tedder if we want to do some hay. And then right here we have our mowers. I just went ahead and just did a basic setup on the mowers with a rear deck and a front deck. We can always upgrade as we go. And then we have this one. I think this is a mod. Pretty sure it is a mod. It's Berthoud or whatever, the Dark Vantage. It's something different. Never used it before. I've had it in my mod folder for quite a while, I believe. Or maybe it came with this pack. I cannot remember, to be honest with you. But I've never used it, so I figured I would give it a shot. And, so we have our Amazon. I have used this one quite a bit in some other maps. I absolutely love it. So I'm going to use it in this one as well for the fertilizer and lime. Then over here, we have our weeder. Again, just something different. We also, you know, with the sprayer, if for some reason the weeds get too tall and we can't take care of it with the weeder, then we have that there for herbicide as well as liquid fertilizer. Then we have our lime and fertilizer in this one. So this is actually pretty cool. There's a little room right here that you can access. You can probably store some pallets of eggs or something in, or, you know, whatever. You can fit into this door. You can fit some stuff in here, maybe some fertilizer bags and all of that stuff. Really cool. I love it. I wish more maps would have buildings like this where it has like a room to store stuff in like that, that you have to like hand carry in, because, you know, generally everything is all operated by machinery. So this map is all about hands-on, and I'll show you what I mean by hands-on when we get over there across the map a little bit, just down the road. That's where we're going to be starting at today, actually. So with, let's see, that, we come in here, we have our cows, cow shed, pretty big cow shed. And I'll point something out with the animals here in a minute. This is the coon, just the smallest, TMR mixer that's available, so I figured I would start with this. It'd be easy to maneuver around in here. We could always upgrade to the next stage up if we wanted to. So we have our milk and everything right there. If we come back out right here, we'll take a look at this right here. We have a Roland animal transport. Never used this before, so figured I would give it a shot. It's in the Roland pack, so this is the Rollvan 64. Very nice. So from here, I think this is the other side of the pigsty. So there's drive-throughs in all of them. Now, I changed the manure spreader that it came with to a little bit of a smaller one. This is the FarmTech. The FarmTech VarioFX 750. So this is the manure area right here. It's going to be spawning in. You'll see it spawn in back here. And then go forward and stack up. So we may end up eventually having to move this out, but I'm just leaving that there for now. Okay. Let's move on. All these doors open. Very cool. Let's open this up. This is another little storage area. I figured I would keep equipment out of here and probably store some pallets of stuff, some big bag stuff. So the Ellis Innovations comes with these giant bags of fertilizer and seed and all kinds of stuff. There's also a big bag production thing that you can make your own big bags and stuff. So we'll get into all of that. But I left that open for that stuff. So that's where the telehandler would come in handy. We can get in there. Maybe have to get a forklift. We'll see. Over here, I have our round bale collector thingy. Yeah. this will pick up our round bales. Over here, we just have a couple of various things that were already on the map that I didn't get rid of. Figured I would keep just in case. We have another bucket. A couple of weights to choose from. This is pretty cool. You come up to this. You click on that, and it'll go down, and you can put your pallets and stuff up here, or your implements, or your little, you know, front loader attachments, and then raise it back up. This side does the same thing as well. So, very cool feature. Absolutely love that. All right, so from there, let's go over here. We have our workshop area. And then over here, I stuck this in here because I didn't really know where else to put it just yet. So this is the square bell collector. Yeah, so the little mandor and everything right there. We have a water fill point right there, some gates and stuff that we can go in and out of. Very nice. Trying to be quick about this because we're already 15 minutes in. So yeah, this is where the cows will come out to, in this little fenced in area. Very nice. I believe this is the slurry pickup point, I believe. Yes, I'm pretty sure this is the slurry. Okay, so back here I changed out a couple of things. I went with the Scania mod, and then I just got the curtain side trailer. This will be good for moving around pallets and stuff later on. And then I got this cool little mod right here. This is a Fiat 682 old truck. Figured it fits this map very well. But yeah, I have the grain set up on the back, so we can use this for grain and stuff if we wanted to. I don't think I kept a grain trailer anywhere, so yeah, we'll be using that to start off with. Over here, just the other side of the cow barn, back here we have the calf milking station. Yes, I said calves. So if we go to, if we hit R, we have calves, heifers, cows, and bulls, both in the Holstein and Angus. So, very cool. And we also have ducks, chickens, chicks, ducklings, sheep, lamb, baby, basically every animal variant that we have baby animals, and then we have the middle-aged, and then the older or fully grown aged animals. So we're going to start with some chickens and ducks and stuff in this episode, so I'll show you guys that in just a second. Now here is another spot. This is your mini bales. So you could store 168, and same thing here, you press E, you go in, and then you press Y to take the tarp off, take the bales out that you want, and then you press B to restack the rest, and it will put the tarp back on and store it. Absolutely beautiful insanity, again. So there's also another one on the map as well. Believe it is actually just over there where the blue marker is out in that field. I think that's where the other one is. So I do own that property as well. I'll show you the map here in just a second. So if we come over here, I left this spot open because we're going to be coming in and out of here. This is absolutely amazing. I love this. So this is one of the production area for cheese. So you have your cheese production right here. And you mix all the stuff and everything. And then, you know, you have this area where it moves to, and then you have to take that stuff and move it over to the next spot over here, you know, for like butter. You can make butter. Yeah, so we have another little wagon right here that you can, you know, press E. There's my character in this series, by the way. Figured it kind of fit this map a little bit. So yeah, this little wagon will be handy, and this is a liquid trailer, kind of barrel trolley, universal. So, yeah, very nice. That works the same way as that little cart wagon. All right, let's, from here, I think that is it for the farm. We have our bunker silo just on the other side of this wall. You guys have all seen bunker silos, but I'll take a quick little pink peek at it. This one's very nice up here on the hill. So that's there, and then there's some fields. We own field 3, 2, 5, and 6. So we have a little exit point right there. Very nice. So from here, let's see. Let's go ahead and kind of start closing. I'm not going to worry about all the doors right now. We'll just leave them open. It'll be okay. Don't worry. Yeah, so it's over. I can't remember where the other one is at for the bales, but it's out there somewhere. What is that? Come on. Okay, sheep pasture. So there is another bale stack over there. So, You got a couple of those around the map. Absolutely love it. Now, you can store bales, obviously, the regular old-fashioned way, stack them up somewhere kind of thing. So that's all of the equipment. That is the farm area. So from here, let's go ahead and go over here to the chicken area. So let's, you can see we have chickens in here now. We have our feeder over there, and this is absolute insanity what you have to do with this. If you come in here, you get this wheelbarrow. So we have a feeder inside of here. So you come out, and let's zoom out just a little bit so my character stops spazzing. And then you come over to here, and it fills up your wheelbarrow. And then you take this back over to that building, and I'll show you what we have to do for the water here in just a second. Don't run into the wall. Okay, so you come in here, and then you come up to this right here, and you tip it forward, and it fills the feeding trough. Very cool. And then the eggs are going to spawn in that corner right there, so make sure you leave that all open and free. So this is, the chickens are going to produce poo. So I believe if you go Control Y. Yeah. So it takes the shovel, puts the animation, and then you just kind of walk over the manure or poo and pick it up into there. And then you do Control Y to stop charging. So we'll get this wheelbarrow out of the way. Just kind of park it over here to the side so it's not in the way of the eggs. And then press E to get out of it. Very nice. We can go ahead and close that. Chickens can go in and out of there to get food. And then here is the water trough. So I meant to do this beforehand. I wonder, I don't think we have a bucket over here. That right there is not usable. That's just decoration, I believe, unless the bike is just in the way. So let's move that. And then so that's just decoration. We will buy a bucket really quick. I meant to do this earlier. This episode might be a little bit long. So if we set that to the spawn point for the store, just for easy stuff. So if we come in here to trailers, and then we go to the LSFM farm equipment pack. This is all stuff that comes with the map. And then we scroll through here. You can see we have a bike. We have the wagon that attached to the bike. We have the trolley. We have another wheelbarrow, new, the old one. We have a sack barrow. We have a bigger transport trolley. And then we have the liquid trolley. So if we go into, I think it's miscellaneous. Is it in miscellaneous? Okay, no, it's not. Did I miss it in here? Okay. Hold on. Where is it? It's not. Maybe in animals? No, it's not in animals. Okay, let me find where this is at real quick, and then I'll bring you back. Okay, I found it. It's, so if you go into the objects right here, and then you go to miscellaneous, you have the bucket and a watering can. So we'll go with the bucket. It holds, I think it only holds like 100 liters of water or something like that. But you buy that. And there is the bucket. And then we'll make sure we reset our store spawn point. So let's pick up the bucket. And then you come here to this water fill point. You just hold it under the spigot. You fill it up. Oops. It's actually, keep a hold of the bucket there. Then you come over here to the watering trough, and you don't drop it in. You rotate it, and it dumps into the watering point. So you do that until it fills up. So this bucket will stay here. I'll go ahead and fill up the water. We'll probably need to put some more feed in there as well. So we'll do that real quick. Not sure exactly how much water this holds. So that's 199 liters of water right there. Let's go ahead and fill it up and see if it needs any more. Oh, why is that not? There we go. And you can see the water filling up in the bucket. That's so cool. So from there, okay, so water is full. So we are good to go on the water. So what we can do is just take this bucket and stick it right there. Just in case we need it. And I believe this works as a regular water fill point as well. So you could pull a trailer up here and fill it up. Why is this bucket doing weird things? Okay, whatever. We'll just leave that there. All right, so food. Let's take a look at the animals real quick. Here is the map. Here's our farm area right here. We're going to be over here today. As soon as I get done with the chickens. But yeah, this is our farm layout. We own field 6, 5, 2, and 3. And then we own this area up here. And then we own this area right here. And this area right here. There's a lot to do just on this. So yeah, again, Hof Bergmann is constantly expanding. This is the playable area down here right now. Here is the town area. We'll go down there in just a little bit to pick up a few things that we need. So we need to go into animals and we'll go to chickens, and food is not full. So we need to go ahead and fill them up on food. I will go ahead and do that real quick and then bring you guys back in here in just a second. Okay, we have the chicken food all filled up and the water filled up, so we'll go ahead and close that and let it do its thing. We'll have to replace that bag eventually as soon as it runs out. But from there, let's go ahead and close that real quick, and then let's go into the... Okay, well, I thought we could do it from there. Let's see. Why is it not giving me... Maybe open the gate? Okay, so the animal log dialogue is back here. So if we hit R, we have chicks, chickens, roosters, ducklings, and ducks. Ducklings don't lay eggs yet. They're suitable for rearing or can be sold. Let's see, they provide eggs and all of that. So ducks do. So we're gonna go ahead and buy, let's go with 10 chicks. And then we have, I think we have 20 chickens. We have one rooster. Let's go ahead and buy 10 ducklings. And let's go ahead and buy 10 ducks. All right. Let's go ahead and open up and take a look. Here are the chicks. Very cool. Here are the ducks. And there's a couple of variants of the ducks. So if we go, there's another duck right there. Chicks, and where are the ducklings? Where are the ducklings? They're probably hiding. But there is a duck. There's a duck. Did that not buy the ducks? It says we have 10. Of each, but where are the ducklings? Oh, there's one. Here's a duckling. So they're kind of hard to see, but yeah, that's all of that. So let's go ahead and close up that gate, and we're gonna let that do its thing. Actually, I need to close this door because that's gonna bother me. All right. Now, from here, we're going to go down to the next area that we're going to be working at. But first, what we need to do is go to the, we need to go to the store. Let's actually go to first person here. Disable that menu. So the store from here is going to be, if we go out of the main gate to the left, down to the intersection, make a left and follow that down to the store. So let me go down to the store real quick and I will meet you guys back. Actually, I'll meet you guys at the store because we got to buy some stuff real quick. Pop that open. You can see we have $298,000. We started off with 300,000 euros. We're going with euros because this map is based in Germany. So, very cool. Very cool map. Absolutely loving it so far. Now, apparently there is a speed trap somewhere around here, so we need to be careful. Traffic is off at the moment. Because I will be setting up some auto drive courses, as I do on all of my saves. I know there is a preset auto load thing that I could, a file that I could add in here and just run off of that, but I prefer to set up my own so I know where everything is going. You know what I mean? So, we're at the store area. And let's go ahead and park it right here. And actually, before we do that, let's see, how do you, that's the straps. Oh, there's the button. All right, so we will unfold that. Go ahead and shut that down. So what we need are the, under the consumer goods and the objects. So we'll go to consumer goods, we get these solid fertilizer bags. And there's a reason we have to do this, and I'll show you once we get over there. So, unfortunately, you have to buy these one at a time. So, I just realized I was going to cut on the way to the store. And I didn't. So, yeah. Alright, so there... Where do they... Okay, so they spawn over here, because that is a store right there. So how many do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We have 6 bags of fertilizer. So let's actually move the truck on over there. And we'll probably buy some more. This truck has the Hof Bergmann Farms logo on it, which is very nice. Go ahead and shut that thing down. And then we need to load up all of these bags. So I'm going to go ahead and purchase some more and get all of these loaded up. And then I will bring you guys back here in just a second whenever we get to where we're going. All right, we're coming back into the farm area. We're passing our farm now on the right. And then up here on the left is where we are going. So right here. Now there's no way to get vehicles in here other than using like super strength to pick it up and put it over the gate and all that stuff. But that's okay. This map was designed to not let you do that. So I don't want to do that. We're going to go ahead and make sure that is open. Take the straps off. And we have 12 bags of fertilizer. So we come up here. Open this up, and this is our garden area. We have to do everything by hand. This is awesome. So these are like, they're legitimate fields. So if I wanted to, I could put something like wheat or barley or whatever down in this field with a cedar and everything. I was doing some testing up there on that one. But these are designed to be greenhouses, so yeah, you can't fit any equipment in here, so you wouldn't be able to get a harvester or nothing like that in here anyways. But yeah, so we have an orchard as well for apples. We'll be getting that set up. We have five fields. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 up there. We have a little open area right here. This right here is grapevines. Okay, so you can do like a small thing of grapevines right there. So over here, I've already got some tomatoes running in this one. So it works just like a production point. Walk up to it, press R, greenhouse. And you can activate whatever you want in here. Now we have the addition of cucumbers, cauliflower, and onion. And we only have 5, so we're going to do tomatoes, lettuce, cucumbers, cauliflower, and onions. Strawberries, yeah. We may be able to do those eventually. But for now, yeah, we'll just do those 5. So you have to fill it with water and fertilizer. So I'll show you that in just a second. So what we could do is we come up here. And nice little area. We have a little garden shed right here. We have a wheelbarrow. We have, I put this wagon here. This is the fertilizer bag I was using to test that field. We have a watering can and a bucket. So if we take our bucket and we go down here and we fill it up in this water point right here. It's actually already filled with water. So we come over to the field, same thing that we did with the wheelbarrow earlier. Oh, nope, we don't want to throw it. We don't want to throw it. That's not what we do. We take it and we tip it and it fills up the water for this area. Now it holds 200 liters. The bucket is only 100 liters. So you have to do each field twice with the water. So yeah, this is like tedious work. Yeah, but this is what the map creator intended it to be, is do this garden by hand. So that is what we're going to be doing. So I will get the water put into this, into these fields, and then I'll bring you guys back in for the next step. Okay, we got all the fields, gardens watered, and we got the orchard watered. So now what we need to do is we take this bag of fertilizer. Go ahead and use this one since we already had it testing the other field right there, the other garden. They're already starting to come in. So if we come up to the field, you can see all we have is water, and now we have fertilizer. It took the rest of that bag. So I believe it takes only 20 liters of fertilizer. So if we go into the productions, and we go here. So yeah, 20, let's see, 19 there, and then 220. So yeah, so just 20 liters. So it takes half a bag of fertilizer. So now what I need to do is, since this one is ready, I'll go ahead and show you this. So if we hit R, we are on garden field 4. And this will be lettuce. So we have our water, we have our fertilizer. Let's go ahead and activate that. And now we have lettuce in our garden. So cool how this is all set up. Like, this right here should be standard in the game. You know what I mean? This is just absolutely amazing. I will go as far as saying this is possibly the greatest map ever created on Farm Sim. I'll say it. You know, there's some things here and there. You know, obviously this is a continuous project. So, you know, there's going to be little bugs here and there with stuff, because this stuff is just not heard of in Farm Sim. So, yeah, it's absolutely amazing. Oh god, oh god. Alright, let's go back this way. So we're going to take our cart down to the truck and load up our bags of fertilizer and bring them in so we can get these fields fertilized and do the same thing with the other ones. So once I'm done with all of that, I'll bring you guys back in and we will finish up getting these fields, these gardens set up. Alright, we got all the fertilizer in here, got the wagon parked back up, got all this stacked up neatly. So we all we have to do is come in and grab it and fertilize as we need. So we have our tomatoes going. We have our lettuce going. We have the rest of these fields fertilized. And we are going to go with cucumbers in this field. So let's go ahead and activate that. What did that just do? Oh, I see what I did. Okay, deactivate. And then, let's see. Let's try that again. So we come over here, hit R. That is allotment 3. Cucumbers, activate. There we go, now we have cucumbers in the correct field. Now we could do strawberries in another one with another one. But I think what we're going to do is just continue on what we're doing here. Just one per field, that's all we need. So this is allotment 2, and we're going to go cauliflower. Let's go ahead and activate that. And then over here, go into this one. This is allotment 1, and we will go onions. Let's activate that. There we go. So we have our onions going. We got everything going. Cauliflower, cucumbers, lettuce, and tomatoes. Now here, if we come over to here and we go to where? Apples. Okay, so there's water and then it just stores. So we don't have to do anything with that. Just put water in it and it's fine. So that's all set and ready to go. Now if we go to grapes, if we were to put water in there, let's see what happens after a little while. So let's go ahead and grab the water bucket and do this again. So I think it's probably gonna hold 200 liters like the other ones, but we'll see. If I can hold on to the bucket, that would be nice. Right there. Go ahead and fill it up, 100 liters. And let's pour this onto the grapes and see. Nope, that was the wrong button. That's 100 liters. And let's go ahead and fill up another one. I think this right here is actually water. So let's go ahead and do this. Okay, I thought this was water. I could be wrong. Okay, anyways, let's move on here. Let's go ahead and fill this up. There we go. And then we'll come back over here and drop this in to the grapes. I'm kind of curious to see how these grow, because we have our traditional grape vines that we can do, you know, placed down through construction. So I'm very curious to see how that's going to grow. So we'll drop that right there. And we can go ahead and close this up. And if we come into here, back into productions, and we go to grapes. So it looks like it takes more than 200, but let's leave that 200 in there and just see what it does. And then, you know, come back to it. So with that, let's go ahead and drive back to the farm. We'll close up that gate. And then we'll close that up and get this going. Just turn around here. Nope, this is not the right way. All right. Get up here to the farm and get this parked back in the garage. And I think that may be it, because I don't really have anything else that I wanted to get done, and this episode is already running on very long. Let's hop out so we can see what we're doing here. So we'll get this backed into the garage. Alright, that's in the garage. We'll go ahead and close that up. And what we need to actually do is go ahead and set our time 5 times for the speed. And Yeah, so I believe I'm running 2 day months. Yes, 2 day months. So we are in August at the moment. And yeah, that is going to do it for this episode, you guys. Hopefully you enjoyed. I am so excited to get going on this map. This map is just absolutely incredible. As I said earlier, I will go as far as saying this is the greatest map ever on Farming Sim. So yeah, check it out for PC if you have not already. And yeah, I'm so excited. Hopefully you enjoyed. If you did, hit the like button. Feel free to comment down below with any tips, tricks, comments, or anything like that, suggestions. And subscribe to the channel if you have not already, and I will see you guys in the next one.